inside yourself.
Hey guys, it's your girl Valery Ortiz here, and you're watching American Latino TV, celebrating American Latino Pride. Now, every week on this show, we enjoy bringing you the Latino impact on American culture. But oftentimes, we run into stories where American culture influences Latin American art. Take our first story. Bajo Fondo is a band consisting of 8 musicians from and including the legendary Gustavo Santaolalla. The band, which refers to itself as a collective of composers, singers, and artists, was formerly called Bajo Fondo Tango Club, but shortened the name to Bajo Fondo after their style had broadened with the influence of electronic dance music. Now, Bajo Fondo looks to invade American shores with their hybrid electro-tango sound. So put on your tango shoes, turn up the volume, and check out Bajo Fondo. Sonidos, brought to you by Chevrolet.
I would say I like to compare sometimes music with football, with soccer. It's really a team. We really admire each other in the band.
Bajo Fondo started as almost like a lab project. I think the different backgrounds and the different ages and all that and the different activities, it all adds up to make it a better band. We do have a part of all of that, a lot of things in common.
Playing with legendary Gustavo Santaolalla might be an honor for Adrian Sosa, but even more importantly is what the musical collaboration that is known as Bajo Fondo means to them as innovative artists.
Rock in the 60s was taken by the young people around the world and became somehow like the folk music of their youth. We had that in Latin America, and I was part of, and I'm one of the, I think, pioneers of that in Argentina. I always thought that we had in Latin America as good and sometimes even better talent than the one that, you know, came out of the United States or of England. But I also learned from my own experience since I was a kid that they, when they would say they, would say the people in the United States and in England, because I was in Argentina still, right, make these unbelievable sounding records, and they make these unbelievable albums that the songs were like, you know, perfectly crafted and all that. And then we couldn't get, you know, why, you know, with the talent that we have, why can't we make records like that? And that was one of my big objectives when I got heavily into producing rock and español, to make sure that we could make records that were as good as their records. I signed my first record deal when I was 16 years old with RCA, and I started my career then as an artist and as a producer, because they were not such a thing as alternative music producers at the time. So I had to produce, and I was a big fan of the art of making records. I was always looking at the albums that I like, and I'd say the Beatles, and I would look and I'd say produced by George Martin. The Kinks, and it would say produced by Shel Talmy. The Who, produced by Kid Lambert. Donovan, produced by Mickey Most. So then I started to learn what these guys did and what was it. So I was very interested in the whole process of making records.
Vamos.
This amazing quality of Gustavo as a producer is that he studied first the what he's gonna do, then he sort of plan or visualize what he wants to achieve, and then he works together with the artist.
I always really try to bring out the best of the people that I'm working with. But I think part of what allows me to enjoy so much the experience of Bajo Fondo is what I learn also producing other people. Because I like, to a certain extent, I like much better playing with Bajo Fondo and being in a band in which I am sharing music, we are writing music together, we're creating music together, than doing my solo project. And people ask me sometimes, hey, you've done so much. You still have any? Oh, I have many things I still want to do.